So in this video, we're going to talk a little bit about samples and populations, and we're going to try and connect the two ideas. In intro statistics, we're often alternating back and forth between the idea of a population and a sample. So first, let's talk a little bit about a sample. Okay. We can think of the example of, say, taking a sample from a population, say of size 100, and we're going to calculate some variable x, recording if they have a particular disease or not, and record it as yes or no. And suppose in our sample, we find that 12 do have the disease. Here, our x variable is categorical, and so we're going to summarize this using a sample proportion, which we'll label p hat. Okay, here we can think, out of our 100 individuals, 12 had the disease in the sample. So our sample proportion is 0.12, or 12%. Okay. We can summarize this using a bar plot. And again, we can think of, here's our variable x, if they have the disease or not. We're looking at individuals who do and who don't. And on here, we're going to look at the probability of having the disease. So we can see in our sample, 0.12 people did. And 0.88 did not. Okay, and this plot here describes for us the distribution of our sample. Okay, and again, the idea of a distribution is a very important concept in statistics. In module 1, we learned all about summarizing a sample of data, different ways to collect data, make summary plots and summary statistics. Now, let's think about what if we could know everything about the entire population. So suppose we knew the true probability of having the disease within a population. Here we can think of modeling this or using a probability distribution to describe this. So this is the idea of a theoretical probability distribution, and these are described in module 2 of the course. So continuing on this example, suppose we knew at the population level, suppose we know that the true probability of having the disease is 10%, okay, and some other conditions are met. Here we might think of x being whether or not someone has the disease, as following a binomial distribution, okay, with parameters n trials, p being the probability of success, here 10%. And again, we can think of describing this using a theoretical probability distribution. So it's the exact same concept as this bar chart over here, except rather than being for a sample of data, this is for the entire population, and we're going to assume here we know the truth about it. So again, we can think of someone has the disease, yes or no. And in the population, we're going to suppose we know 10% of the population has the disease, 90% do not. Okay. And so again, this here is the binomial probability distribution, or we can think of it as describing the population's distribution. So what we'll do in module 2 is we'll learn a bit about the binomial distribution, supposing that we knew the truth of the population, and this can help us understand when we collect some data, how likely are certain things to show up in a sample. If we know that 10% of the population has a particular disease, and we randomly select 100 people from that population, what's the chance of observing 12% of people in our sample having the disease? Now, let's take a look at another example. So let's think of an example now of taking another sample out of a population, and let's suppose we randomly select 100 individuals from this population, and we record their height. And again, in centimeters. Okay. Here, our x variable height is a numeric variable, And so to summarize this, we're going to calculate the sample mean as well as the sample standard deviation. And again, when we have this data, to summarize it graphically, we can think of making a histogram or a box plot. So let's take a look at using a histogram here. Along the x-axis, we've got x, our height. We can think of heights going from 140, 170, 200. On this axis here, again, this describes the probability. And we might see something like this showing up. Okay, and again, this here we can think of as describing the distribution of our sample. For our 100 individuals, what was the mean, what was the standard deviation, and what's the distribution of their heights? Now, we'd like to move into a world where we could suppose, what if we knew the truth for the entire population? So what if we knew the true mean, the true standard deviation, and the true shape of the distribution? Okay, so let's think here of that. Now, at the population level, suppose we know that the true mean height is 175 centimeters. We know that the true standard deviation is 10 centimeters. And we know that x, being the height, is approximately normally distributed. And the normal distribution is something we'll formally introduce soon. So here, we're thinking that at the population level, heights might be bell-shaped and symmetrically distributed around that mean of 175, or the true mean. Okay, and again, we can think of this here. Well, this is the normal probability distribution. And we can think of it as describing the population's distribution. So again, here's living in this theoretical world where we suppose, what if we knew the true mean and true standard deviation? What if we knew the true histogram and the entire population was bell-shaped and symmetric? See? So it might help for the time being for you to visualize a series of bars if it helps you connect the idea of a probability distribution, in this case the normal distribution, to a sample of data. Okay, now, in a real world, there's nothing that is perfectly normally distributed or bell-shaped and symmetric. A lot of things are approximately bell-shaped and symmetric. Okay, and again, we can use the understanding that we're going to build up here to say, if we knew the truth for the entire population, how likely are certain things to show up when we collect a sample of data? If we know that the true mean is 175 centimeters, what types of sample means are likely to show up when we collect some data? Okay, again, building up this understanding of if we know the truth, how likely are certain things to show up in some data, is going to help us to do statistical inference. Given our sample of data, what statements can we make about a population? So that's going to be our next topic for discussion.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to our channel. Like our videos. Share our videos. I love statistics.